Good evening.
Good evening.
I have a story, and today I'm going to present it in a different way. What way poverty helps to succeed in life? I'm a successful businessman, according to many. They ask me, what are the reasons of your success? I search for reasons, and there are no other reasons except that I was a very poor man. So what this poverty has empowered me with, right? This was in 1959 I was born. Five children were in the family in a small village, and my father was neither an employer nor an employee nor a trader. There was nothing known as a sweater at home or a fan in the roof, nor any luxuries of birthdays, parent-teacher association, nothing was there. No apples were purchased, no Horlicks was purchased, and even finding a third meal itself was a very difficult task. Five classes, one teacher was the first school I went to. And empty intestines teach you wonderful lessons. And I want all of you to understand that I became a graduate only because in Tamil Nadu, those days, meals were given in schools. I don't have a photograph of my school, but I vividly remember in one hand a slate, in another hand a plate. No other gadgets. One to eat, and if you don't take a slate, they won't give you food. So this was my school memory. The first 10 years went, next 10 years, part-time education, no full shirts, no full trousers, and no footwear. I can't remember in my school I was wearing a footwear. No dictionary, no atlas, no guides. And no picnics, no games, no group photographs. Sounds like I have come from probably Gupta, Aryas, Mauryas time. But let me tell you, this was just in 1970. No textbook was there for me in my 12th standard. But I scored 200 out of 200 in mathematics in 12th standard. There was no food, no shelter, no travel. Everything had to be earned. I'm just telling you what were going on in those days. So in 1970, I have worked for 1 rupee per day. Then it grows, and when 1980, when I started getting 250 rupees a month, it was 10 rupees a day. So I had to tell a white lie to my mother to leave home, because if I tell I am getting only 800 rupees salary, my mother will not be keen to dispatch me. I set it to 1600. And the good children are those who give 75% of the salary to mother, and I wanted to be still a good child. So I reached VT railway station and slept in VT railway station for 3 nights. Government job I got, and I had to send 75% of it to my home, because all those who love their family have to make sure they support the family. Because I said my salary is too high, I have to earn additional salary. So 5 part-time jobs, 2 tuitions in the morning, 2 tuitions in the evening, and there was a part-time job in Surat in Saturday. Well, what poverty gave me was an ability to focus, the frugality and the discipline. Got married. Double salary now. My wife also is earning, I am also earning. And alongside, after marriage, after having 2 children, I did my MSc and a PhD also. 7 marriages, not all for me. 7 family members, my wife's side 3, my side 3, and mine, all put together, 7 marriages I conducted. 2 children, both are mine. And finally bought a scooter, thinking that, wow, life has come to some kind of comfort zone. So, I have never traveled anything other than second class in Mumbai, though we were both government officers. Never traveled any scooter, any car, any taxi or auto. No EMI. And my income was only 5,000 rupees per month. Comfort zones had set in. And 2 lakh was there in my closing balance of savings bank account. Then I decided, now I can resign and risk in life. So, rented a garage in South Mumbai. Worked only in the night. I slept in a toiletless laboratory. I'm a businessman. I'm an entrepreneur. Fortunately, I did not know the spelling of entrepreneur. I slept in the toiletless laboratory, and a single specialty I chose, because had I had money, I would have started a multi-specialty laboratory and collapsed. Because I didn't have money, I focused on one gland. I studied a B2B model, because without money, if you have to do the business, it has to be B2B. Mind you, everything is forced upon you because you don't have money. A franchisee model and a single laboratory. Finally, I have journeyed without an investor from outside. Never I have borrowed debt for my company or for myself. Mind you, all strength comes from poverty. I want all of you to understand the entire journey is having a background of the courage of poverty. So this is how May 1995, I got one sample. Then 5 samples a day, 10 samples a day. When that year 2000 came, I had 2000 samples in a day. Mind you, the business generates enough revenue and enjoyed doing that business without borrowing. Uniqueness, I do a pathology, which is, I'm a mathematician. I do pathology, so it is a numerical pathology. I only employ poor and freshers and those who cannot speak English. Mind you, when I was looking for a job, everybody asked me, do you have an experience? And today I know, you can't get an experience before giving a job. So for all my 1,000 employees, I'm the first employer. Price low, very unique, chased volume, and a lean process I have developed. Mind you, I have never taken salary in my company. There is no expenditure for me because I don't go out of my laboratory. There is no travel for me because I don't need a car also. And I have not holidays for 20 years because when you are enjoying, you don't have to go for a holiday. Fortunately, no neighbors. Fortunately, no relatives and no peers. I think I cut off myself completely from the rest of the society. And no house, no car, and no club class. That's my style even after becoming a $500 million worth company. No clutter, no fear, no EMI. I want all of you to understand, if these three are there, that means you are in heaven. Enjoyed all the way. I romanced with risk. Don't take it other way. I planned to lose because I left a government job and I thought, let me invest 2 lakh rupees and see what business I can do. Stamina is the currency. Mumbai is a place where people with money cannot make money. People with stamina can make hell of money. Frugality is my ammunition. Poverty taught me how to use money. And that's the most important thing I have ever learned. Simplicity is the luxury. The lighter you live, the more fun it is. And consumed just 0.01% of what I have created. I want all of you to understand, to become a billionaire, you have to consume less. Cost of food is $2 per day. Mind you, if you eat for tongue, it is $2 per day. Sorry, eat for intestine, it is $2 per day. If you eat for tongue, it is $10 per day. If you eat for your eyes, it is $20 per day. And if you eat for your nose, it is $40 per day plus 28% GST. Burnt calories, not salaries. I want all of you to understand that calorie is the currency. Stamina is the currency. So this is my value. Values, value and valuation as told by Velumani. My name is Velumani. I thought my company is worth 200 crore. No one knows what is your company's value. Your own value, no one knows. I just guessed, but I didn't want to sell. I told 400 crore. No calculation, no spreadsheet, nothing. Straight away 400. They bought 20%. Somebody else came. I thought if I tell low, everybody will buy. I told 600, another 10% was bought. One more guy came, I straight away told 1200. Another 10% was done. Mind you, it reached finally for an IPO at 2400 crore valuation and got listed at 3600 crore valuation. 75 times it got subscribed. First time in the stock market the company has got such a wonderful reception. And when somebody told, I am the 49th richest Indian according to Business World, I was extremely happy that with the 500 rupees I came to Mumbai and I could reach to a position which makes me to feel I have got a story to tell. A 2 lakh rupee in hand, I start a business and it becomes a 4000 crores company simply because I had frugality, I had understood what is focus, and I had understood what is discipline. Added 5 zeros in last 30 years, and I am just 58, and Warren Buffet is 38. I've got another 30 years to go, and love to die while walking or running, not on the bed. This is how I see myself for next 25 years. Fortunately, I was from a village. Fortunately, I am from a poor family. Fortunately, I am from Tamil Nadu because those guys cannot speak Hindi. And I have learned very fast Hindi here. Not a doctor, fortunately. Not an engineer, fortunately. Not an MBA, fortunately. Fortunately, one company which I was working also got closed down. Fortunately, I resigned a job which I was having a government job. Fortunately, I did not know where thyroid was when I joined in BRC. Look at it. Everything was fortunate. I have seen all the 10 slices of the pyramid. Born in the bottommost slice of the pyramid economy, you make 10 slices. I was born in the bottom of the bottommost slice. And I am in the slice number one. I have traveled through and through in this pyramid. And I know how many people stood there itself, how many slowly went up, how many went down, how many fell down. I can recall in these last 58 years of journey, what way people have succeeded in their life. So, luxury of poverty. Success is delta. Delta is equal to x2 minus x1. Mathematicians' way of telling success is delta. Delta is x2 minus x1. Two innings in life. If first innings is all pains, second innings will be all pleasures. If first innings is all pleasures, second innings will be all pains. Luxury of poverty. Enjoy if you have got. Celebrate if you are poor, because there is no downside for a poor. There is always a challenge for the rich. Enjoy pains. If you have started enjoying pains, there won't be any more pain. I want this to be taken in right spirit. Do not fall in honey. You know, honey bee collects honey. Money bee collects money. If honey bee falls in honey, what happens? It dies. So is the money bee. I want all of you to understand, don't become a victim of money. Frugality and poverty are always together. When somebody is poor, there is no other choice, you have to be frugal. But unfortunately, even there also stamina and poverty are always together. If somebody is poor, he has higher stamina. And if somebody is poor, he has highest discipline. And I want to understand, all of you to understand, poverty has made this man very powerful. Teach children frugality. I think once you have taught your children frugality, you don't have to make money for them. They will enjoy their life. Don't pamper children. Parent them. My mother didn't pamper me. She only parented me. This is the punchline in one of the South Indian movie. Be alone and be a lion. Take less to get more. In business, if you take more, you get less. So you have to take less to get more. Act poor. Many of the people, you know, normally people act rich. That gets you EMI. If you act poor, you will be the happiest man on this earth. Four words I want all of you to remember. Focus, learn, grow, and enjoy. If you don't focus, you can't learn. If you don't learn, you can't grow. And if you have not grown, you are not entitled to enjoy either. Please don't change the order. Everybody likes four words and start from enjoy. Do not become KPM. Want to know what is KPM? You need to take risk. You need to be restless and do something. Otherwise, you will be called as KPM. Kaya, Pia, Margaya. And I want, if you want to become a billionaire, if you want to become a billionaire, there are only three ways of becoming a billionaire. One is, you should be a billionaire son. I think plenty of you have lost the opportunity, right? The second option, you should be having a father-in-law who is a billionaire. I think that opportunity has also gone for majority. The third one is SBADNK. Does it sound like a South Indian political party? No. SB, seedha baito. AD, apna dekho. NK, mehnat karo. Thank you very much. This is a tribute to my wife who made me the most powerful man. Unfortunately, she is no more. She was a victim of pancreatic cancer and I just lost her some 18 months back. And she is the most powerful lady, became the successful man. And she only made a poor man a rich man. She only made this man a self-made man, I call myself. Self-made entrepreneur, I call myself. She was the lady who made me. Thank you very much. I enjoyed a lot. Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you.